The most common question that most of the students of Carnatic music have is, how do you learn to sing raga lapane? Do you write the notation of the raga lapane and by heart it? Or do you listen to the recordings of raga lapane and try to reproduce the same? Or you try to make your own sangatis? Well, every one of us have a different approach in learning raga lapane. Before going into this discussion, I am going to give a brief introduction on what raga lapane is. Raga lapane is the expansion or elaboration of a raga. The spontaneous improvisation of a raga through aesthetic arrangement of swaras to show the structure and extent of that raga is called as the raga lapane. Raga lapane consists of various patterns and combination of swaras in different speeds. So let us see as what are the aspects that one has to note to render raga lapane. First thing, arohana and avarohana of that raga. So when I say arohana and avarohana of a raga, what are the things that comes in? The swaras that are there in that raga. Does the raga has prakriti swaras, shadja and panchama? What are the vikriti swaras that are there in that raga? Does the raga has a rishabha, a gandhara? If there is a rishabha, then what rishabha is it? Is it a shuddha rishabha? Is it a chatushruti rishabha? Is it a shatshruti rishabha? And so on. For example, if we take the raga maya malama kaula, sa de ga ma pa dha ni sa sa ni ra pa ma ga re sa. This is the arohana and avarohana of raga maya malama kaula. It has the swaras shadja, shuddha rishabha, antara gandhara, shuddha madhyama, panchama, shuddha daivata and kakali nishada. So these are the swaras that are there in the raga maya malava kaula. Once you know what are the swaras that are there in that raga, you have to concentrate on the sequence in which these swaras are placed. So in maya malava kaula, the sequence in which the swaras are placed are very straight. Sa ri ga ma pa dha ni sa, sa ni dha pa ma ga re sa. The order is very straight and there is no vakra sanchara. Whereas in ragas like riti kaula, sa ga ga ma ni dha ma ni sa, sa ni dha ma ga ma pa ma ga re sa. So whenever you sing riti kaula, you have to make this vakra sanchara. Ni dha ma ni sa, ga ma pa ma ga ri sa. This vakra sanchara is a must in raga riti kaula. So the sequence of the swaras in a raga is also very important. Now comes the question, is it enough if you know the arohana and avarohana of the raga to render a raga lapane? Well, that's a no. Every student of music has to know about something called as Raga Dasha Lakshanas. Raga Dasha Lakshanas are the 10 characteristics of a raga. They are Graha, Amsha, Nyasa, Tara, Mantra, Alpatva, Bahutva, Audava, Shadava and Apanyasa. Among these, it's very important to know the Amsha Swara. Amsha Swara is also called as Jeeva Swara because it gives whole life to that particular raga. It enhances the beauty of the raga. For example, in Raga Kalyani, tadana na ra na ra na na ra na 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 ra tadana na na. That is Nishada. Nishada happens to be the Jeeva Swara in Kalyani. Nishada gives life to Raga Kalyani. It enhances the beauty of Raga Kalyani. Then comes the Grahaswara. Grahaswara is the starting note of a raga. For example, in Raga Mohana, Gandhara, that is Antara Gandhara, is the Grahaswara. So how do you get to know that Gandhara is the Graha Swara in Ragamohana? For that, you take examples of previous learnt compositions.
Nannu palim nadachi vachetevo.
It's a very popular composition in Ragamohana, which starts from Ga. And then another kriti,
Dayarani, Dayarani.
This particular kriti also starts with Ga.
Ga pa ga sa, ga pa ga ri sa.
And if we take the example of the very popular varna in Mohana,
Ninnu kori ga ga ri ri sa sa ri ri ga ga ri ri.
The varna also starts from Ga. So what we can say is, from most of the compositions that are found in Mohana, we find that Gandhara is the Brahaswara. Then comes Nyasaswara. Nyasaswara is the ending note of a raga. So, note to start and note to end is very important while you are rendering a raga lapana. After this comes the Gamakas. Gamaka is the ornamentation to the swaras. So there are varieties in gamakas also. Well, it's important to know as to what swara, what gamaka is allowed in what raga. All gamakas cannot be used in single raga, or a particular gamaka cannot be used to all the swaras in that raga. For example, in raga Kalyani, Nishada has the Kampita gamaka. So Nishada has this Kampita Gamaka. You cannot use the same amount of Kampita Gamaka to all the swaras in Raga Kalyani. Or you cannot use the same amount of Kampita Gamaka in all the ragas that has Kakali Nishada. So only certain Gamakas are allowed to certain swaras in certain ragas. Along with Gamaka comes the concept of pace. The pace in which you have to render a sangati or a sanchara. Whether you should sing a sanchara brisk or you should sing the sanchara slow by elaborating the sanchara. So it's very important to know as what pace is ideal to a particular sanchara. Another important aspect is to know if a raga is scale oriented or phrase oriented. Certain ragas can be built or elaborated based on the arohana and avarohana of that raga. For example, ragas like Maya Malva Gowda, Shankarabharana, Kalyani, Mohana, Shanmukapriya, Kiravani, these ragas are built based on the scale of that raga. Whereas ragas like Athana, Devagandhari, they are phrase oriented. That is, they have certain key phrases. And you have to sing those key phrases often in order to expand that raga. So these are the key phrases in raga Athana. So when you sing raga Athana, you use these key phrases often in order to elaborate the raga. Then comes the syllables to be used in raga lapana. What syllable sounds pleasing and decent while you are rendering the raga lapana? The very traditionally used syllables are ta, da, ri, na. If we listen to the recordings of many legends, they have also used ta, da, ri, na very often in their raga lapana. Akara and ikara are also very often used. Ukara is used sometimes in raga lapana. Ukara is not really used very often. Only at certain places ukara is used. Otherwise, akara and ikara are majorly used in raga lapana. Above all of these, clarity in whatever is sung is very important. Clarity in singing sancharas, clarity in the gamakas, clarity in ending phrases, clarity in the swaras being right is all very important to render a neat alapane. And then it is said that the more number of compositions you know, the better your raga alapana can be. You cannot just randomly do alapana in a raga that you have not been introduced to yet. If you know a varna, a couple of kritis and other compositions in that raga, then your raga alapana can be a lot better because you understand that raga and you have good idea about that raga. Along with learning more number of compositions, it is very important that you listen to good music. One has to listen to a lot of recordings of legends and stalwarts of Carnatic music. One has to attend live concerts. That gives a lot of experience and ideas about Carnatic music. After all these comes the question, do I have to learn all this before I start to learn raga alapane? Well, no, that's difficult. Because this is not something that you read, you learn and then by heart and then probably try to implement it in your singing. It is something that comes in a course of time. You learn, you understand and then try to implement it in your singing in a course of time which you will be taught by your teachers. In the very initial stages, you cannot learn all of these first and then start to learn or sing raga alapane. In the initial stages, you just follow whatever your teacher has taught you. Few points that you have to remember are, try to reproduce the sangati the same way as taught by your teacher. By doing this, you will not be going out of raga. You will not be singing a sangati that is probably not allowed in that raga. You will be singing the gamakas right. So, try to reproduce the sangati the same way as taught by your teacher. Second point, listen to the class recording for a number of times. Third one, do not by heart. Listen to the class recording. Get ideas. Try to get those small nuances right. Take a few sangatis from the recording and try to make your own sangati. Do not by heart the whole set of sangatis. Fourth point, listen to recordings other than the class recording. That is, listen to the recordings of other artists in that particular raga, which will give you a better understanding about that raga. Fifth point, try to create your own sangatis. While you are at practice, it is okay if you are making mistakes. It is okay if you are going out of the raga. It is okay if you are singing a sanchara wrong. Remember, it is while you are at practice and not on stage. So, when you are still in the initial stages of learning raga alapane, these mistakes are ought to happen. Anyway, you will be corrected by your teacher in the next class. But do not leave the effort of trying to create your own sangatis. By hearting the whole raga alapane, writing the notation for the raga alapane, singing the whole 4 to 5 minutes of alapane exactly the same way is not the solution to learn raga alapane in a long term. Listen to a lot of recordings, learn from your teacher, but try to sing raga alapane on your own. By doing all of this, I am sure you will be able to render a very good raga alapane in course of time.
To watch and learn from more such videos, subscribe to our channel and don't forget to press the bell icon.